Dr. C. Sujata, renowned professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, IIT Madras.
Right from about 3,000, 4,000 years, people have been doing work on this. The Greek scholars and the people in the Indian temples, they've all been studying vibration and acoustics. So I will try not to make it very heavy. I'll try to make it pleasant for all the school children. What exactly is vibration theory? It is concerned with the study of the oscillatory motion of bodies, both longitudinal and transverse waves. Longitudinal waves are like the sound waves we are studying. Transverse waves are this kind of wave, where the wave is propagating perpendicular to the direction the machine is producing. If you place it inside a normal room and make the measurements, all the walls of the room and the ceiling and the floor will be reflecting. So what you are going to measure is not the actual sound produced by the machine, but it is going to be the actual sound plus the reflections. So if you want to get rid of the reflections, you use what is called an anechoic chamber, a chamber with no echoes, anechoic chamber. So this chamber will have foam everywhere on the all floor, on the ceiling, on the floor, and somewhere at mid height they will have a platform on which they will keep the sound producing device.
I'd like to thank our speaker, Dr. C. Sujata ma'am, for enlightening us with your knowledge.